Here at Life and Football, we're talking about Erik, a DB for the Oakland Raiders. If you haven't looked him up, go look him up. His story will make anybody, any walk of life, go out and work for what they want. You're going to have to sacrifice. You're going to have some discipline. And you definitely going to have some hard work mentality day in and day out to get what you want. And his story represents that to the T. Listen, man, the man, you already know. If you don't know, he had to walk on to a D2 school. He did amazing there. He didn't get drafted. He didn't go get no NFL invites for mini camps or workouts. So he worked for a year. He worked for a year without a college degree and figured out right then and there what I wish all players and anybody in the real world would understand. You need that college degree to put you at a certain level of living. Because it's hard without a degree. It's hard without a degree. So players or anybody listening to this, you need that degree. It just bumps you up pay scales for, I don't know, they just do it. With a degree, they'll put you at their star job way higher than a person without a degree. That's just how it goes. Not at all jobs, but a lot of jobs. Now, on top of getting his degree, after he got out of school, he had to go back to school to get the degree. When he went back to school to get the degree, he not only had a job working at 9 o'clock at night, getting off at 5, going home to sleep a few hours, then get back up, go to class. After class, work out hard. You know why he working out? Because he said, man, forget this. I need my degree so in case I don't go to the NFL or don't get no shot playing football, at least I have my college degree and I can get a better working job than the job he had before the 9 o'clock job. Now, he goes and he's grinding. So he's in shape. Now, once he's in shape, guess what's going to happen? While you doing everything you're supposed to do, an opportunity will come. So opportunity came. He drove up to Buffalo, New York to take advantage of the opportunity. Now, he had to pay $80 on top of driving up there just to try. Now, a lot of people will say, hey, man, if you got to drive up there plus pay money, man, you know it's probably a scheme. It's a hustle. It's a scam. Man, nobody ain't gonna call you, man. Ain't no teams gonna be looking at you. Nah, he went here and none of that. He went up there, paid $80, balled out, and guess what they did? They called him. Now, 2 or 3 days later, after he get the call, and they tell him, I guess they want him on the team or whatever the next steps was for the CFL. He gets on the team. Now he's on there. Now you would think from there, oh, it's going to be fine and dandy. He good to go. But listen, it's players in the CFL that stay over there the whole entire time and have a nice career in the CFL and never make it to the NFL. But not his story. He wanted that NFL. So he grinding 3 years there. Look, everywhere he been pretty much balling out on special teams. So if I'm a player, a couple of things I done heard already. Get my degree and make sure I'm balling on special teams, period. Now, he's balling, doing well, doing good. One of his partners made it to the Saints. So they put in the word for him. Hey, man, we got a ball up there in the CFL. Y'all need to go check him out. So, you know, the NFL, they gonna look into what they need to look into. They gonna check everything out. Probably watched all his film. Probably called everybody they need to call to see what he was about. Brought him in for a workout. The man balled. So you thinking, yes, I done made it to the NFL. But guess what? He tears ACL. So now what you going to do? You going to cry about it or you going to get back up and grind? Man, the man got back up knowing it's, again, sacrifice, discipline, hard work. Got back up, grind through it. Got the knee healed up, ready, rolling, balling. So now guess where he's shining at? On special teams again. Players, y'all got to see special teams as a key to get to that NFL on top of whatever you're doing. Now, I know some positions can't play on special teams. It be like that sometimes. Or sometimes you ball so hard, they don't want to put you on special teams. But, man, if you probably ain't no first or second rounder, you're going to be on them special teams, period, when you go to the NFL, if you get that shot to it. So he grinding, man. The whole story is him grinding day in and day out. I wish somebody emphasized that, man. He's grinding day in and day out. He's grinding right now to this point with the Oakland Raiders. He got to grind day in and day out because every year that he's on that team, they're drafting players. They drafting these boys, coming in young, running fast as ever, can tackle whatever. Man, listen, he's still grinding. He looking at the bigger picture. I know he looking at the bigger picture. He probably grinding, saving his money, putting everything aside. Got kids that he want to put through college and have scholarship money for him. Want to make life easier. Not saying easier, but make it better. Make the setup better. So they could jump off his shoulders and jump higher. Then they kids can jump off their shoulders and jump higher. Man, listen. It's grind, grind, grind. It ain't going to be easy. It ain't going to be easy. Whatever you want, no matter the walk of life, it won't be easy. Go put in that work and get what you want. Believe in your dreams and you can get there. But it's going to be on your sacrifice, your discipline, and your hard work.